Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how to make realistic grass in Lumion. Okay, so we've already opened Lumion. This is a default mountain scene. And what we've done is we've come to landscape, and under landscape there's this paintbrush, and you can see that this swatch here has a little grass symbol. So if you select any of these, it'll add grass to that landscape texture. So if I hit cold grass, it'll color like that, or even if gravel, it'll get like this white look or gray look. So just be aware of that. So like if I come in with the paintbrush and let me zoom out a little bit. Start. You know, I can do stuff like this, but then whenever I select this this paintbrush here, that'll be when grass starts to grow. So there's that. And then there's also this little tool here, which is really the cool thing. Let me change this back to something that makes a little bit more sense. Let's do clovers. Yeah, I like this one. When you click on grass, you can then customize the grass size. So this will just change the how the size of it, basically the scale. Now grass height, for a lot of mine, I usually do high grass because it covers the most. And then wilderness, I like to get enough. This is what I do, but it looks patchy if you do this. So I like to get enough so that it varies in height, but so that you don't see the underlying texture. So wilderness to go like something like that. So you get a little bit of variation in height, but you're not seeing the underlying texture. So there's that. You can also turn the grass off altogether by clicking that little icon. There's also these types. You can add like random things that will be placed throughout your grass. You can change the spread or the size of those. I usually like to maximize random size when I do something like that, just so that it feels more natural. Obviously, there are rocks in here as well. And you know, mess with that kind of stuff, and as you zoom around you'll see more rocks. So there's that. I'm gonna get rid of these, just showing you that you can do that. And then the other way to get grass is to actually place an object. So this is like a really good uniform let's get grass everywhere. There's also objects in, so if you click objects and then go to nature, there's also a section for grass. When you go to your objects, you can see grass here. So what I found this is actually really useful for is like if there's little patches of grass or a specific kind of grass that you want, or you just want to add a little bit of variation. So if I put this grass in, it looks pretty cool. And then you obviously, you know, you have some abilities to change the hue, the saturation, what have you. So you have that. And a really nice tool for this is doing mass placement. So selecting, basically this is your area. Zoom in so you can see what it looks like, and then you can change the number of items so that it can be more or less dense. So this just gives like more, I like this kind of grass, you know, if you're doing like a low shot or something, or you're rendering, this grass can look very stale because there's so much of it. Like, you know, if I'm doing a top down shot, you can start to see the tiling of that. But if you're doing a top down shot of this, it looks better because there's more variation. And you can even add, you know, a different kind. So let's say we want this rough grass and just reduce that or whatever. So you can just get more variation through actually placing objects, but it's going to take more processing speed. So these are the ways to make grass. I think I showed you a few different ways. You have the paint brush that you can use as grass, and you can either toggle that on or off, and you can edit the grass in there. And then there is an object. You can place a grass object. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.